Okay, so it's nice outside, so I opened the windows and thought we'd take a look at this little console stereo. I've had this for a while and I've done multiple videos on it. Unfortunately, one of our pets keeps thinking that this is the bathroom over here and it's nice and sticky over here and it's been leaking under this thing, and you know, this whole thing's particle board, and when this thing gets wet, when particle board gets wet, it swells and it crumbles. So, yeah, but I really wish that they still made these. Imagine if Crosley made one of the, made this, had the same, like, finish on them, and have, like, their cheap record changer, which their record changer was basically like a copy of the BSR, but cheapened out. But imagine if they had one. It would basically be like the Crosleys that are the cheap Crosleys that are, like the all-in-one systems. Imagine that, like it's stereo part and it's record player part, but in a cabinet like this. That'd be so funny. But yeah, I wish they still made them exactly like this. With the, for some reason I have an affinity for these cheap plastic and particle board stereos. I love this crushed velour, or crushed whatever the hell this is. It's like some kind of fur. But I got some records today and figured we'd test them out, but I'm gonna open this up and see if I could fix the 8-track, since I've been trying to mess with 8-tracks lately. I have another one of these stereos, except it's probably, I don't know, this is from like, I think like 76, 77. That one's from like 68, so, and it's made out of real wood. Like, it literally, it uses the same 8-track, uses the same chassis, except that one's lot less plastic. So probably what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna, because I'm probably just, but is I'm gonna keep that one, because it actually, I need to clear it off and fire it up, because it was okay for what it is. It had an 8-track player problem just like this one, and you can see this one, it's stuck. So let's try and see if we can fix it. First, you're gonna want to unplug it, and you never see anything like this with the same plug anymore. Okay, let's turn that on. Morse Electric. Oh, that one's branded, the older one's branded as a Morse. Made in Japan. If anybody can tell me, the BDD, so BDD, don't know what that means. Okay, so I took out this little piece and now it doesn't change tracks, and you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to disable the 8-track player. I'm just going to leave it there for aesthetics. And probably what I'll do is maybe, I don't know, maybe add, maybe cut a little piece of this crappy particle board here and add some RCA jacks or something. The thing doesn't illuminate anymore. Still plays though, but you better like what's on the fourth track or program. They should really come out. They should really start making these again. Please. Let's not play this one, because Carly, that ugly troll-looking, horse-looking bitch, she'll get triggered and take down my video. Let's try this.
Number 9.
didn't realize it. This was the live version of Gimme Three Steps. So now I'm going to find, hopefully, the not live version, the studio version of it. You can see how nice and quiet.
We've only just begun to live.
Unfortunately, this and a lot of their other records were, or singles, they were pressed onto styrene, so they don't hold up worth a shit. This record's cracked, unfortunately. And it's styrene, too. But before we do that, let's... You never see anything like this with this plug anymore. And for those of y'all wondering, that iHome brand that's made by the same company that made Sound Design. Okay, let's pop this tape in there and see what the hell it does. Oh, well, you know what? I just had a Joe Biden moment. Gotta plug it in first. You can see how quality this material is. still says 60 cycles, so I think that happened about, like, maybe, I'd date this no later than 1972 or 3. They should come out with cases like this again, these disco cases. I wonder if the patent's pending or not. But yeah, they should come out with containers like this. They should make them again. Let's see something. Patented. Patent pending. One of them's patent number. Made in USA. All the supply chain crap going on. You'd think they would start. Oh yeah, let's ditch crap made in China and let's bring manufacturing back home. Picked out a couple songs we could play. Probably get copyrighted, copy strikes, but whatever. Here's a really shot copy of Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Damn it. A little high pitched.
Oh yes, wait a minute, Mr. Postman.
We got this Varco cartridge installed. Yeah, it works. Okay, let's try this shot power pack record. It's got Leroy Brown on it, but Power Pack was one of the, like, Pickwick International, which I think Pickwick's still around, but I don't think they release anything anymore. I know that Drew, Sound Alikes have been around for many, they've been around for, I think, I don't know, probably like almost 100 years, even more maybe. It wouldn't be complete without including some Barking Pumpkin Records featuring Valley Girl. Featuring Valley Girl. Like, totally so bitchin'. The album title, Ship Arriving Too Late to Save a Drowning Witch. Is that like the ships all stuck out in the ocean trying to dock in California? Because the witches, they won't let them. They saved a drowning witch on the way home. This. Not now. That's the song. This is weird. This record doesn't really have like a proper transition from one track to another. This is what it does. Here's the amplifier board. This is the speaker I put in it. Some little junky TV speaker. I have the guts out of a Panasonic or Panaphonics TV I parted out. I took out the little speaker assembly, and that's what we're going to put in the Fanola. I really wish that they still made record players like this in this cardboard case, like this, with like the big 4-inch or the 4-inch speaker here, the nice Alliance or General Industries drive mechanism, this same exact style of tone arm and cartridge and amp. Let's see what this does. Well, this thing, here's the cartridge. It's a Varco cartridge. It's a Varco SNH-45, patent pending, Japan. Now, I really wish that they still made record players with this same exact tone arm, like the same plastic design, like. No, but I really wish they still made record players with the same exact kind of case design, same exact drive mechanism, speaker, amplifier, and tone arm, and cartridge. But they don't, which sucks. This is, okay, I've featured this Telex Fanola a couple times. Brian, or Radio TV Phono Nuts, used it, or did a video on it. Fanola warranty. Parts list, see, this was back when, they meant for you to fix it. Now they tell you, oh, throw it away, go buy a new one. This platter's really nice. I remember I replaced the speaker in this, but I think I may redo that and kind of hear the drive mechanism.
Mountain cold and clean, the unborn grass lies waiting for his coat to turn to green.
Here's the oh, and this is the same brand as that stereo. It only has AFC, it doesn't have, you can't switch that off, but it has 2 3 channel speaker systems. Doesn't really do much because you have to hook up 2 speakers in the back.
Anyway, they are going to continue to go up. Areas specifically that you talked about that are really going to have dramatic increases. You know, we want to make sure that homeowners, future homeowners, purchasers, are aware of what their risks are so they're making informed decisions.
Yeah, all that, the socialist agenda spending bill, that's going to hike taxes up on the middle class because all they really care about is the wealthy and the elites and themselves. They don't care about the middle class at all. And they're like people on Black Friday, spend, going to debt.
Listener-supported ministry
I've been able to pay off.
Right there, I'm doing.
The day you graduate from your program.
I'll show you what the tape player does. Thankfully they make this semi easy to get into. Hold on. Brought in some bigger reinforcements. Whoops. Okay, I got the thing out of its hole. Here's the inside. This is the thing that's not moving. This little track change thing's moving, but not the head. Thing looks like it belongs in one of those awesome basements. It's got a bar in it with the wood the beautiful fake wood paneling and the orange shag carpet and the early American style furniture. That's what's missing from this. Oh, and the smell of Boone's Farm, Strawberry Hill, and cheap cigarettes. Out of all the renditions of this, this is my favorite one by Tex Stewart.
Born on a mountaintop in Tennessee, the greenest state in the land of the free, raised in the woods.
This is also a little golden record. It's a 78. It's on it. It's the same version, which is kind of funny. This looks like they ripped off the Atlantic logo. Would you actually believe they still sell this? And they sell it at Walmart, and I just hope they never stop making it like this. I love the pan. I just love its design. But I just hope they never stop making Jiffy Pop. Home for the Holidays. I think this may be from 1975. You can see the lights there. Yeah, let's not put that in the window. I don't want it to get even more brittle. Cartridge. This record's completely just trashed. You can get me another one, because this is that crappy styrene shit. See it? You can see through it. See it? You can see through it. That's how you can tell it's styrene.
And it's dinner time, we stopped and walked back to the house to eat.
All the plastic vibrates on this damn thing. Here is a Vanity Fair record player from, maybe about, I'd say, it says, it would help if I put in a cartridge that was good. This is the record player that it's in, and if I ever found one of these, if one showed up on eBay, or at a thrift store, or a flea market, that was in good shape, that was a price I could afford and I could live with, I would probably pick it up, because this one, I lost its little cover, and you can see this handle. This was like rubber or something, but I bet most of them are like this by now. But this is from 1966, made by Philco Ford. I think this thing sounds better than a Crosley Cruiser. Mittens. Yeah, I think my cat agrees. I really wish that they still made record players like this with this kind of cardboard case. This same kind of amplifier, this same kind of AC motor driven alliance or general industries drive mechanism, and this kind of tone arm, like this same kind of plastic design with this same cartridge, which is this Varco cartridge. Let's go ahead and put this back in the Vanity Fail. Super Hits 1973 Gusto Records Power Pack, and they did the 16 greatest truck driver hits, and this thing's doing something stupid. So these records, or these record players with 78 on them, with just the fixed non-flip needle that had 78 on them, they really just intended you on playing these little ones, not standard 10-inch shellac 78s with the wide groove. These are little micro groove vinyl kitty 78s.
And I hold the blue and exchange the green lilacs for the red, white, and blue.
Let's go ahead and play this QMO, right? Yeah, oh, Allshire Records.
Feeling small. just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed. Nothing seems to fit. Boom, raindrops are falling on my head.
And here's, Snowbird right here, this little tiny track here, and it's like not even a minute. This thing's gonna need some help. A few months ago I put a speaker in this. Let's go ahead and take it back out. Oh, there's a screw under the plastic. There's the speaker in there. I got the, there it is in there. And it's kind of bad how it's connect, because the little studs on there broke off, but should be okay. Let's do a bass test.
You can burn in the VIP in the chill. Plenty of joke, plenty of cup. Oh, girl, you're so fine, you got a nice style. With your one flat of my game is guaranteed. I'ma hit you. Stick that cool shooter, work that cool shooter. Stick that cool shooter.
Yeah, it works pretty good. This is some garbage crap.
I'm a stone and chip to go in. Shake that boo shooter, work that picture. Shake that boo shooter. In your ass production. You can come in the VIP and just chill with. Eat plenty of troll, plenty of liquor. You got a nice style, which is one flat of my game. It's guaranteed. It's guaranteed.
In your production. In your production. Shun, shun, shun.
Made by Philco Ford. This is where that cartridge was. I have a cartridge sloppily hacked in here. I think this Varco cartridge is still good, but it doesn't have a needle, and it's got that, and I don't have this little tiny screwdriver to get to that.
Come in.
Note, certification of million sellers by Record Industry Association of America, RIAA, pop chart positions by Billboard and Cashbox magazines. 1970 is certain to make musical history. It was the year that saw a merger of various forms of musical expression. For instance, music that would originally be considered country consistently showed up on the pop charts. Songs like Cracklin' Rosie, Arizona, Rainy Day in Georgia. The same was true of soul and rhythm and blues. And 1970 was a year that produced three songs that should become all-time classics. Let It Be, Bridge Over Troubled Water, Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head. Golden hits of 1970s, both were million sellers. Both have been number one on the pop charts. To reorder, send $2.95 for one album, $5.50 for two QMO sales, Incorporated 500, Jericho Turnpike, Mineola, New York, 11501. We're going to have to go Google that later. But here's the catch. See how it says, yeah, golden hits of 1970, million sellers, top of the charts. First you'd think, oh yeah, this is some pirate album. Nope. Mm-hmm.
up, cracklin' Rosie, get up. We're gonna ride till there ain't no more to go. Taking it slow.
And that stupid sounds the feedback from the damn cartridge. Have a good one of these, so I'm not particularly ruining one that's good.
But they wouldn't match the glow of your eyes.
This song is called Candida. That's some kind of disease. Has two screw or one screw under the platter here. Now for some real music.